Thank you very much. So, hello, good morning, everyone. Close. My name is Nicole Finkelstein. I want to take GlobalMed to invite me here. I recently graduated from medical school, but I didn't take the path of all my classmates did, that is to go to hospital for such a postgraduate training. Instead, during the mandatory year of community service you have to complete to get your medical license in Mexico, I enrolled in an MBA program. During this time, I realized that there is much more medicine than a clinical side. There are also public health issues that need to be addressed urgently in order for our society to progress. Telemedicine is a field that I found especially interesting and innovative, a field where much progress can be made and many can benefit. Doctors aren't usually interested in fields such as language arts, communication, or IT. I wasn't before either. Actually, writing speeches and learning to manipulate appliances other than Da Vinci robot and a coffee maker weren't on my list of priorities. In fact, you can ask the people who I work with about my communication skills, and they probably hesitate and think about their answer. However, much to my surprise and to that others, today my days are filled with finding ways to communicate to others the importance of implementing new technology to improve the quality of healthcare to those in greater need. During my time with GlobalMed, I have come to realize how much medical practitioners need communication skills to ensure the quality of their practice, especially when their practice telemedicine equipment. It has just as big contradictory a realization that communication has deteriorated with the advancement of technology. Isn't it ironic? For instance, most of you probably own a smartphone and use it on a daily basis for many tasks. Personally, I hardly remember a phone numbers because my phone remembers them for me. Maybe that's true for many of you as well. Moreover, we rely on text messages a great deal more than we use. Maybe to the point that it has replaced conventional phone calls. In Mexico, a great deal of the population, even those living below the poverty line, own smartphones and have internet access at their fingertips. Technology is becoming more pervasive in Mexico. Last year, eMarketer predicted that 51% of the population will be online by the end of 2013. They also believe that the smartphone usage will see double-digit growth to 2017, resulting in nearly 45% of the population with the phone in the hand. So, now we can acquire health information easily, instantaneously even. We can access medical facts as easy as 123. This, however, may never replace a real-time medical consult, when a doctor needs to see and communicate with a patient and inform the patient what should be done. So we all have access to information, but we do not communicate. First of all, I would like to clarify that informing and communicating are by no means the same thing. Informing is one-size process when the sender emits a message without regards to the receiver's response. This is the same as a patient entering a medical website and reading the information provided. Communicating, its true meaning stems from its etymology from the word communicare, Latin for to share or to place or have something in common, like a medical-patient relationship. So, real communication, the kind doctors and patients need, implies feedback. In the process or feedback, the sender, which in the beginning is the doctor, and the receiver, who is the patient, give and take constantly. Obtaining correct and pertinent information is only the first part when it's sent, received, and comprehended by both parties, and mutual understanding and trust are achieved, effective prevention, diagnosis, and treatment endeavors can take place. So in the consult, the doctor say to the patient the diagnosis, the treatment, the prevention that the patient has to take. And the patient receives that message. But the way that we are, like a physician, really know that the patient understands what we are want to tell them is the feedback. So they change roles. The patient told the physician what he or she understand, and then we comply the communication cycle. Telemedicine incorporates the new rhythm of information into medicine itself, but must not override the importance of completing the communication cycle. This is a picture that we took in Mexico in a rural clinic. Moreover, it can and must be part of the current lifestyle of patients who are in constant connection, aiming towards the improvement of health system and medical services by incorporating social and cultural factor in this approach to the population in need. Challenges in Mexico. In Mexico, for example, as many other developing countries, one of the biggest challenges the public health sector faces is to make quality medical services universally and easily accessible. Facing this challenge is key to achieving the right to health services as mandated by our national constitutions and by the human rights declarations. The factors that contribute to these problems are many. Great distance between first level clinics in rural communities and second level facilities in cities. Understaff institution dealing with high demand and consequently the lingering of the wait time to reach specialized attention. Inefficient use and allocation of resources. This results in the worsening of many patient conditions and unnecessary rising cost. The next images you will see is the shocking truth in Mexico in the public health system. The patient waits 1 hour, 2 hours, even days to get a medical consultation. Okay. Most of all, returning to my point, the lack of communication between the three levels of medical attention, especially in the public sector, is the consequence of the absence of the holistic connection and communication web or network. Exemplifies the Mexican public health system. This is a pyramid. The Mexican public health system is divided in three levels. First level is the primary healthcare, outpatient clinic, family physician, and rural hospitals. The second level of attention are the hospitals in the city, and the third level of attention, research institute and highly specialized services. They don't even know what happened in the first level, second level. It's a mess. It's a totally a mess. They don't have a communication network. A crucial step towards improving public health system in Mexico is the establishment of communication among medical practitioners in all the three levels of attention: rural clinics, city hospitals, and research institutes with highly specialized service. So my theory is if we put telemedicine equipment in the three levels, the communication network will be improved and they will be continuously in a connection. So the practitioner have a connection between the three levels. Using telemedicine, there is a case that we made in Mexico. The first image is the physician making an ultrasound to the patient. And here is the second level facility. In my experience, the general practitioners that engage in a teleconsultation with a patient has to be mindful of the fact that he's the eyes, ears, and hands of the specialists on the other side of the screen. In reference to the other factors I mentioned before, such as crowding and understaffing, I have seen how government entity called IMSS, Mexican Institute of Social Security, the largest public health network in the country, has begun to incorporate telemedicine to A, further expand its range of attention patients in rural community and clinics, B, to enhance communication between three levels of attention, and C, to diminish redundant transfers of patients from faraway rural community clinics to second level attention hospitals and clinics. Now we're going to watch what is happening in Mexico.
Recent development in information technology and medicine have established telemedicine as a cutting-edge option, breaking physical barriers that allow specialized medicine to reach its full potential. Telemedicine makes possible diagnosis and even surgical intervention support for patients in primary care clinics, especially those located a long distance away from cities. The American Telemedicine Association, ATA, defines telemedicine as the use of medical information exchanged from one site to another via electronic communications to improve a patient's clinical health status. Using transportable exam stations, TES, Medicut stations and medical peripherals such as HD medical examination cameras, ophthalmoscopes, and others, video conferences can be done with image exchange, vital signs monitoring in order to make a diagnosis and establish a treatment plan. By establishing new medical assistance centers equipped and prepared for telemedicine and telehealth, the benefits reflect in timely diagnosis, decrease in medical transfers, keeping electronic medical records that prevents doubled files, making access to patient medical charts easier, quicker and truthful. Furthermore, telemedicine overcomes geographic barriers and limitations, making possible and effective public health services.
The results I expect from the implementation of telemedicine in the Mexican public health sector, bearing in mind the recommendation I just shared as to their communication, is the decongestion of second-level facilities and the considerable improvement in their activity and problem-solving capabilities of first-level facilities. This will increase the range of attention little by little until it becomes truly universal. Okay, this is the connecting communication networks that we are doing in Mexico. So we can see the outpatient clinic with the transportable exam station of GlobalMed, because the outpatient clinic in Mexico are in the rural communities, like 5-6 hours away from the city. So this is really a long distance. And then we have the hospital that we putting the Medicards at the equipment, the big equipment of telemedicine, and the mobile physicians. So we can have a communicator network in all the country, no matter the long distances we have. If we take this model, we have a lot areas of opportunity, like the Navy, oil industry, natural disasters, prison facilities, autodiagnosis in the patient house. And then you say, okay, it's very easy to introduce telemedicine in Mexico. But no, don't think for a second thought that introducing telemedicine equipment to various institutes in our country has been easy. Breaking paradigms of practitioners who have used traditional equipment for years and years, even when the advantage of GlobalMed equipment are clear as day, is a challenging task. However, we have managed to introduce this technology first by diagnosing the needs of each institution and finding the equipment's utility in each specific clinic. And second, by creating an effective communication network, reinforcing the already existing one, we have also succeeded in lessening the resistance to the use of the telemedicine equipment by imparting rigorous and comprehensive training sessions. The results have not been less than stellar thereafter. Doctors have found the great utility and diagnostic capabilities in the appliances. This experience further exemplified and has reaffirmed my belief that the current transmission of a message and adequate communication can break barriers that were once thought unbreakable. I think, and maybe most will agree with me, that the responsibility of any institution is to contribute to a true communication, of real understanding, to generate profound and transcendent cultural changes for the greater good, always respecting the value of the knowledge each and every group possesses. In sight of the revolution, in the way we communicate, the health sector faces the challenge of not just informing, but of procuring the real transmission of knowledge to help the prevention of diseases, promote healthy habits, and give timely medical attention. In this era, we have to realize that converting virtual into real is completely possible. Telemedicine is a phenomenon that could, by the way of the virtual, translate into real an actual reduction of cost and resources, and could considerably improve the productivity, quality, and efficiency of healthcare worldwide. So I really want to express my grateful to the Mexican Institute of Social Security, because it's the first entity in Mexico that accepted the challenge to innovate our public sector in medicine. So this is a big opportunity to all the patients in Mexico that have to wait even months to have a diagnosis in Mexico. So this is really a step forward the future in the medicine, and telemedicine is the solution for the Mexican people. And thank you. If you have any question, please let me know and we can make the feedback that I told before.
Do you have any kind of telemedicine in the schools that connects back with the clinics, or is that not something that you've gone into yet?
Yeah, we start a program in, there is a telemed school. It's a high school that all the equipment the children use is a computer. Also in Mexico, we have a virtual clinic that called eClinic 24. And there is a web page that the patient can consult the physician. So we gave memberships to all that children in the school. And then in the school, they can connect in the internet and consult a physician face to face. So that's the start we are meeting in the school in Mexico. Yeah.
Another question?
No? So thank you.
Nicole, thank you.
Thank you.
That was very nice.